Welcome everyone, this is Kids Yoga and this is the fourth episode, the fourth time we're practicing together. Now, today the idea is that we'll work a bit with our hips, opening our hips. And when it comes to the pelvis and the hips, in yoga we often assimilate it with movement and flow. So today it will be a quite dynamic class. We'll be moving around, we'll be a bit intuitive. Intuition is when you're trusting that voice within and you don't overthink. You don't think about what you're going to do. You feel rather than thinking and you do what you're feeling. So I'm very excited about today's class because we'll get to be a bit more dancey and a bit more intuitive. And I would like to hear from you afterwards, to hear what you thought about this class, how this was different than previous classes. Because in previous classes, maybe we held some poses more, we stayed still. Today, it's not so much about stilling the body, but we do want to calm the mind down again. So that's the challenge. You want to stay present. You want to stay with your body when it's moving a lot. You'll tell me how difficult you found this after the class. So already, if you want to, you can sit in this butterfly position. If this is not comfortable for you, then you can sit on top of a cushion so that you feel a bit more lifted and a bit more comfortable. Maybe your knees are closer together, that's fine. You work with your body. Everyone's body is different, and that's part of the lesson today, that you're unique and your intuition, the voice that you have within, is specific for you, is unique for you. So with your feet together, bring your feet as close to the body as possible and try to open up the chest. Don't overdo it with rounding down. So send your pubic bone, the front of the pelvis, send it back and send the chest up and the shoulders back so that you're sitting up tall. Start by concentrating on your breath again. Breathe all the way down to your hips. And exhale through the mouth. Try to relax the hips. Two more times. Inhale deeply all the way down. Open the mouth and exhale. Last time. Inhale. Breathe in. Down low. And exhale. Breathe out. Beautiful. Open your eyes and start to move your knees up and down. Imagine that you're a butterfly in this butterfly position and start to flutter your wings. And maybe you can go a bit faster. Remember to keep sending your pubis back and to keep the chest open. Keep breathing deeply. Relax the face and relax the hips. Be careful not to hold on to any tension, any stiffness in the jaw, in the face. So relax the jaw. You can fake a sigh, open the mouth wide, and just release any tension there. Any tension here will translate to tension on the hips. So we want to keep the jaw soft so that our hips are comfortable and they relax and they can be open today. Again, it doesn't matter if your hips are not as open as mine or maybe they're more open than mine. That's just you. Beautiful. Okay, so from here, start slowing the movement down. And bring your hands to the knees, pull the knees together. come to your pony position. And in this pony position, hands are under the knee, the shoulders, knees are under the hips. You press down into the hands and you bring the right knee in and you bring the right leg back. Exhale the right knee in and inhale the right leg back. Three more times. You can allow the spine to follow the movement. Breathe out, knee in, round the back. And breathe in, take it back, arch the back. One more time. And then bring the knee down. Press into the hands, keep the right knee under the right hip. And exhale the left knee in. Inhale the leg back. Knee in, press into the hands, leg back, straighten the leg. And then breathe out, bring the knee in, round the back, push into the hands, leg back, two more times. Round and breathe in, arch, breathe out, and breathe in. And breathe out, bring the knee down. Okay, now we will open up the right hip. So you'll bring the leg to the side and down. Bring the leg to the side. And down, open the hip and close it two more times. And keep your chest facing down. Other leg, press down into the hands, into the right knee, and bring the left knee up, take it down, up, take it down, keep your body strong. Knee up, take it down to the side, and down one more time. And take it down. And now we will open up, breathe out, bring the knee forward, and breathe in, open up, and take the leg up. So the toes are facing to the side, and I'm kicking up. Three more times, breathe out, and breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, and breathe in, and take the knee back down. Left side, push into the hands, bring the left knee to the side first, and then knee in, leg back, knee in, leg back. Keep your core strong, your body strong, kick back, breathe out, and breathe in, back. One more, and then take the knee down. Knees together, feet together, come to your child's pose. Relax here like a child, a good, good child. Breathe into your belly. Breathe out. Then breathe in lower down to the hips. And breathe out through the mouth. Relax. Breathe in. And breathe out. Good. We're going to do our transition. Snake to dog. So breathe in, come to your pony, bring your chest and your chin down, breathe out, breathe in, slide to a snake, feet together, open up the chest, breathe out, push, tuck the toes and come to your dog. Again, breathe in, plank, breathe out, knees, chest and chin, hips are up, breathe in, slide to a cobra and breathe out, push back, dog. One more time, breathe in, breathe out, knees, chest and chin, breathe it, slide forward, and breathe out, dog position. Breathe in and bring your right leg up, and breathe out, open up the hip. Breathe in, bring the leg to face down, and breathe out, open up the hip, bend the knee. Breathe in, straighten the leg back. Breathe out, bend the knee, and then from here, draw circles. Open up your right hip one way, and then the other. Go the other way with your knee. And then straighten the leg, point the toes down, and take the foot down. Left leg, take it up, and then breathe out, open up, and breathe in, close the hip, and breathe out, open up and bend the knee, and breathe in, straighten, close the hip,
and breathe out, open, bend the knee, and draw circles. And then the other way. Extend the leg, square the hip, and take the foot down. Good. Bring your knees down and breathe out. Come back to child's. Breathing slide to your cobra pose. And breathe out, push child's pose. Breathing to your cobra pose. And breathe out. And now start to be a bit intuitive. Breathe in and maybe you want to move from side to side, slithering through. And then breathe out again. Maybe hips move to side to side as we go back. You can breathe in and move in one direction. Open up the chest in one, in the other. Breathe out and go back. Make this into your unique dance. So move as you need to move. Maybe stay somewhere more. Open up. And maybe as you go back, you even tuck your toes to come to your down dog position. And again, keep coming forward as you breathe in and back as you breathe out. Three more breaths. Take this as your opportunity to dance with your hands down, with your feet down. And then with your unique way, you find yourself at the front of your mat. So find yourself going to the front and just releasing there in this drag doll position, wrapping opposite elbows and relaxing here. Again, from here, start to swing from side to side. You can keep your knees bent at any point of the class. And then press into the feet, bend your knees, and start to unroll up. Come all the way up for your sun salutations. So bring your arms up, open the chest to say hello to the sun. And then let's start doing our salutations. Breathe out, bring your hands down. Breathe in, bring the right foot back, knee down, open up. Breathe out, knees, chest, and chin. Push down with the hands, keep the hips up. Breathe in, slide forward, snake. And breathe out, push with the hands, dog. Breathing the right foot forward, bring the hands up. Say hello to the sun, and breathe out, come to the front of the mat. Fold forward. Breathe in, press to rise up. And again, open up the chest. And breathe out, come down right away. Bringing the left foot back, knee down, open up. And breathe out, push with the hands, knees, chest, and chin. Breathe in and move forward. And breathe out, push to go back. Bringing the left foot forward, open up. And breathe out, keep moving. Even if you're not doing it the way that I'm doing it, press the feet and come up. And we'll do two more sun salutations, but you go at your own pace. So breathe out and close, and breathe in and open up. Be intuitive. If you need to do anything else, you can move from side to side. Again, today it's for you to feel what's happening with your body and dance around on your mat. So this is the challenge. This is the difficult part. You should keep yourself with the feet where they are, with the hands where they are, and just move a bit forward and open up as you need to. So keep it flowing, keep dancing, and keep breathing. Stay with your breath. Do one more sun salutation. Remember, every time you breathe in, you open up and you say hello to the sun. Every time you breathe out, you close in, you say hello to yourself. So stay with the sun salutation, stay with your breath, move in the way that you need to move. We'll meet at the front of our mat very soon.
So move however you need to move.
And come to the front
and rise up. Take your time. We'll meet at the front and we'll do our flamingo pose in a different way. So stand at the front, stand still for a second just to notice what's happening. How are you feeling now after all of the flow, after all of the movement? Can you stay completely still? Can you stop yourself from moving? What's happening in your head? How are you finding this class? Is it difficult for you to be intuitive, to move without thinking? Or is it easier for you when there are no rules, when you just follow what you feel like doing? There's no right answer. Just think about what's happening with you, with your body and with your mind. What works for you best? From here, we'll move the right leg up first into our flamingo and we'll again play with the right hip. So the hips are now square, they're facing forward. If I open up the hip to the right, then now it's an open hip position. And that's what we'll be doing with the right knee up. So press down the left foot, keep your left leg strong and straight, and then breathing, bring the right knee up. And breathe out, open the leg to the side. Breathe in, bring the knee in, maybe even twist slightly, and breathe out, open to the side. Breathe in, bring the knee in, pull the knee closer. You have the option of grabbing the big toe and straightening the leg. And then breathe in, open up again, and breathe out, bring the foot in. If it's too much, stay with the knee bent. Breathe in and breathe out. One more time. Keep your body facing forward. Breathe in, open up and breathe out, close it. Straighten the leg and use your muscles to keep the leg high for three breaths. Keep pressing the left foot down, left leg straight, 4-2. And then see if you can bring the leg higher up, 4-1. And then breathe out, bring the foot down. Good job. This is not easy. So whatever you did is perfect. Press the right foot down, strong right leg. Keep the right leg straight. This is how you're grounding down so that you can feel open with the left leg. If you're not stable, then your left leg cannot do much. So you always have the option of grabbing onto something if it's too hard for you. So now you know because you did the other side. So try to work with this side according to how you felt on the other side. Press the right foot down, keep the right leg strong, and then breathe in, bring the left knee up. Breathe out, open up to the side. Breathe in to the center. Breathe out to the side. And breathe in to the center. And maybe slightly twist. Breathe out, open up. Good job. And then if you want to straighten the leg, you can. And then breathe out, stay open. And breathe in, close. Breathe out, open. Keep the standing leg straight. One more time. And then from here, keep the leg strong and bring your hands to your waist. Three breaths. Keep the leg high, 4-2. Straighten both legs, keep the chest proud. For one more breath, and then breathe out, bring the foot down. Very good job. Now we're going to our goddess position. So open up the right foot to the right, and open up the feet so that they face out. From here, we bend the knees, and we go as low as we can while keeping the chest proud. So keep your feet strong, bend the knees, pull the belly, and open up the chest. If you need to be higher, be higher. If this is comfortable, then open up the arms and turn your palms up. Goddess position. Sit a bit lower, open up the chest, breathe in, and breathe out. Maybe come a bit lower, Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. And breathe out. Breathe in, push to come up. Breathe out, bend the knees, come down. Two more times, breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in, keep your legs strong. Press the outer feet down, breathe out. Breathe in, come up. Heel toe the feet in. So close the feet to shoulder width apart. So your feet are under your shoulders. Keep your toes facing out. Bring your hands to your chest. And then from here, bend into this yogic squat. So you might have to bring the feet closer and sit up tall. Again, if you need to bring the heels up, just like we did in the previous classes, that's the option. Keep your elbows pressing the thighs so that you open up the hips, the chest. Breathe in here and breathe out through the mouth. Bird position. Bring your hands forward, elbows in, push down and round your back. So I'll turn so you can see me better. You want to really round your back. Rounding through the back, gaze forward, so look forward and bend the elbows. Keep looking forward, forward, and push into the hands. Maybe you can bring one foot up, maybe both. Keep pushing down into the hands, even if the feet are on the ground. Breathe in and breathe out. If you come down, you can try again. Press down, keep the elbows in, push into the hands, and shift all your weight forward, round the back. Maybe bring one foot up, maybe both. Breathe in, breathe out, press into the hands, round the back. Breathe in, and breathe out, come back. Frog position. So from here, we'll bring the knees down, and we'll take the feet to the ground. So now my knees are quite open, and my feet stay behind the knees. This is your frog. If you can go lower, then come to the forearms. You don't have to. You can stay up. Keep your belly strong. Breathe in and breathe out. You want to push a bit back. Breathe in forward and breathe out. Push back. Three more times. I'll just turn so you can see me. Breathe in and breathe out. I push back. Two more times. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Stay here in this frog position for three breaths. Breathe out through the mouth. Good. Bring your hands down, push, shift the weight forward and bring the feet in. Press down with the feet and bring the knees in. Come to sit back and open up the knees back to this butterfly position. You want the feet to be as close to your pelvis as possible. Use your hands to open up the feet just like a book and open up the chest and breathe out, come forward. Maybe you can come all the way down. Maybe you stay higher. Stay with what works for you. Breathe in to the hips and breathe out. Think of sending your knees down to open up the hips more. Breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Press the feet together, breathe in, come up. Use your hands to close the knees and now open up the legs, open. So you don't want the legs to be horizontal, just in between, in front of you and to the sides. So they're diagonally to the sides. Flex your feet to activate your legs. Feel that the thighs are working, the quadriceps here, they're strong. Keep your feet flexed, press the heels down, feel the thighs working. Send your pubic bone back, so the front of the pelvis, sending it back, open the chest, and fold forward. Breathe in, pick up the chest. Breathe out, come a bit further forward. Breathe in and breathe out. Think forward, not down, forward. Breathe in and breathe out, come forward. Maybe you grab the outside of the feet. Maybe you stay high. Breathing and breathe out through the mouth. Two more breaths, breathing. Keep your feet strong. Breathe out. Breathing. And breathe out. Breathe in and come up. And then breathe out, turn to the right foot and reach. Breathe in, come up. Breathe out, reach the left foot. Breathe in, come up. Breathe out, reach the right. Breathe in and breathe out the left. Good. Right hand to the left. Breathe in, left arm up. Breathe out, reach. Breathe in, come up. And breathe out, reach. Breathe in. Breathe out, reach towards the foot. And breathe in. And breathe out, stay here. Maybe you grab the foot, maybe you stay high. Breathe in, open the chest. And breathe out, reach away through the hands. Relax the head, breathe in. And breathe out through the mouth. Breathe in and come up. Bring your left hand to the right. Then breathe in, reach, breathe out. Again, follow your own breath and reach. And then reach away and maybe grab the foot, maybe stay up. Reaching away through the hands, keep the feet strong. Breathe out, open up the chest, breathing. And breathe out through the mouth. Breathe in and come up. Use your hands to bend the knees. Good job. Take the legs forward and then breathe out. Come forward. Relax. We've moved a lot. We've moved quickly. So now we start slowing it down. Keep your legs straight. Keep your feet flexed and keep your head relaxed. Think again of sending your pubic bone, the front of the pelvis, back and use your muscles to pull the chest forward. Keep the feet strong, keep the thighs working and keep the head relaxed. Three breaths here, breathe in and breathe out through the mouth, breathe out slowly. Two more times, breathe in. And breathe out slowly. Keep your legs strong, the feet flat. And breathe out, relax the head, relax the back. Breathe in and come up. And then breathe out, come back, lie down. Bring your knees in and open up the knees like the butterfly legs that we had before. Place your hands on top of the hips and breathe out through the mouth. If you feel uncomfortable, then you can straighten the legs. Otherwise, stay here for Shavasana, for our final relaxation pose. With all of your attention at the open hips. Notice how you're feeling now compared to how you felt at the beginning. How your hips are feeling. Was it easy for you? Was it hard? Do you feel flexible? Do you feel stiff? And how is your mind? Are you calm? Are you calmer than before? Or are you feeling worse? Was this a hard class and was it hard for your mind? Was it hard for you to do this? There's no right answer. This was not an easy class, but maybe it was easy for you. Everyone's body is different. For this last minute, we stay here, we relax, and we watch. Watch what comes up. be mindful like we were last time. How is your body? How is your mind? Relax completely and watch. Relax and watch. Now very, very gently keep your eyes closed. Start breathing deeply down into the hips. Exhale, breathe out and relax the hips a bit more. And then bring your hands to the knees and close the knees. Start moving the hands, the feet. Start moving the head. And stretch in any way you need to. Start stretching the body long. Reach away through the hands, through the feet. Open up and close the hips. Move in any way you need to. Hug your knees. Roll from side to side. Take your time to do any last movement you need to do. And then come to sitting in your monkey position. So sit up tall with your legs crossed. Close your eyes again if you open them. And relax all the muscles of your body. So with your legs crossed, keep your chest proud. We'll do three lion's breaths. So breathe in and round your back. Breathe out, stick your tongue out, make a hissing sound. Two more times, round the back. Chest and tongue forward. Relax your face, last one. And then sit up tall, sit quiet. And in this monkey position, let's do just a few seconds of meditation. Be still, be quiet, and watch your breath, your natural breath. to your best so you don't move anything. And again, notice how you're feeling now, now that everything is quiet, now that everything is still. How is your body now? How is your mind now? When we know what our body likes and what it doesn't like, and what our mind likes and what it doesn't like, we can slowly start working with it so that we get to work with our body and with our mind. Everyone's body is different, and it's very important to listen and respect what our body needs, but also to help it to get stronger. Maybe some things that your body doesn't like are the things that your body needs. So it's important to know how much the body does and likes, how much the body does and doesn't like, and then with your head, with your logic, work with what your body needs. Sometimes we don't want to eat the healthy food, but our mind knows that that's the best thing for our body. So we have to train ourselves to eat good food, healthy food. Sometimes our mind doesn't want us to do work, doesn't want us to do homework, but we know that that's what will make us smarter and stronger and healthier. Because when we're intelligent, then we can get into good schools, then we can do good things for the world, and we can help, and that will make us healthy and happy. So keep watching what's happening with your body, what the body is resisting, what's happening with your mind, what your mind is resisting, and then slowly but surely you'll get better at things that are hard, and you'll get stronger and ready for everything. Let's bring our hands to the center of our chest and let's finish our practice saying namaste, which means I bow to you, I see you. So thank you for this beautiful class, for this effort and your hard work. Namaste.